हेलो।
हेलो सर।
हेलो सर, इज आई एम ऑडिबल टू एवरीवन?
यस
जस्ट आई एम
यस
वेटिंग
सर,
फॉर
यू आर
सम मैन जस्ट आई एम वेटिंग फॉर 1 मिनट बिकॉज ओनली 22 पार्टिसिपेंट्स आर प्रेजेंट नाउ.
ओके
जस्ट आई
ओके
वेट फॉर 1 or 2 मिनट्स एंड देन.
ओके ओके श्योर सर, थैंक यू.
गुड आफ्टरनून टू एवरी वन. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई थैंक टू ऑल द मैनेजमेंट, प्रियोम्ना मैडम, चिन्नम्मा मैडम एंड प्रिंसिपल मैडम, रेवती मैडम फॉर गिविंग दिस एन अपॉर्चुनिटी टू शो माई स्किल्स इन आई सी टी टूल्स. ओके, इन टूडेज क्लास, टूडे सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द गूगल फॉर्म, हाउ टू मेक द गूगल फॉर्म. द प्रीवियस सेशन वी हैव सीन द श्रेष्ठा मैडम हैज गिवन एज अ क्विज. ओके, शी हैज शोन हाउ टू present she has shown given the Google form to conduct the quiz, and we have attended the quiz. And some people don't know how to create the Google form and how to create the quiz. That in the today's session we are going to see that one. And one more thing, I'm showing the small instrument. Can you see everyone? This is a small digital pad. Can everyone see this digital pad which I'm holding?
Yes, sir, we can see it.
Yeah. So, how this digital pad helps you? So, this digital pad especially helps for the second language teachers to write that, like Hindi, Hindi language, or you can write to teach the teachers the Hindi language, Sanskrit language, Arabic language, and all. And not only that, how we can teach like a chalk and board method, we can use this a digital pad. For using accounts, and also we can use this. This we are two things we are going to see now. So first, how to see? Just I'm going to explain how to make a Google form. Okay. So to make a Google form, first we need to enter to our Gmail account. So first, be ensured that everyone log into your Gmail ID, whatever the mail ID. So after getting the mail ID. Team, can I know? Can I see you see my screen, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
we can
ma'am.
See your screen.
Yes, thank you. So after this, when we are logging to that our Gmail account, you can see this thing, right? So click on this. When you're clicking on this, whatever the apps available in addition to in your Gmail account, this all you can see. Okay. So this all are the like Google Classroom, Hangouts, Google Docs, Google Sheets, Slides, everything you can see. Okay, Google Meet for your conferences and all. Okay, now coming to this, to create a Google, to create a Google form, just click on Drive. Okay, so when you open this, you can see this type of screen. So Google Drive is a place where you can store all your information, all your related documents and all. You can see these are the some Google Forms I have created earlier, which are here. Okay, now to create a new Google form, click on new button. Then you can see Google Docs, Google Sheets, and go to more. Then you can see Google Forms here. So click on Google Forms, a new form will be open. So here we have 3-4 types of Google Forms. Why Google Forms are used? Google Forms are used for research purpose. If you are doing any research purpose, if you want to collect the data from the public, if you want to conduct any survey, then these Google Forms are very much useful. So whatever the data is given by our customers or our students or any other person or stakeholders, that all the data will be stored in an Excel sheet. Okay, that Excel sheet can be downloaded. So we can use that Excel sheet as per our requirement by making the tables, by making the calculations, by making any statistics requirements, by making any graphs and all. Okay. So first of all, just I'm going to show how to create a normal Google form. How to create a normal Google form. Okay, that link I'm going to send to you all. Kindly fill up that, and how the responses you can see, how you can download that, that we are going to see. So first thing that I'm making a registration form and ICT too. So first here, click an untitled form. If you want, you can do that name of the, still I'm saying that ICT tools webinar registration form. Think that this is the name of the form, and you can write the description of the form. Why you are using this form, you can write the description. It's not mandatory. If you want, you can add the description. So here, after the writing the description required by you, you have these options. One is plus points. So here you can see add question. Then you can add the question. Second one is, what is this? Import question. Import questions means sometimes I'm preparing to registration forms. So I want to import the questions from earlier Google form. Then I can click here. I can select the form, and I can add the answers in the present Google form. Okay. Next one is add the title of the description. So if you want to give any description for this particular section, then this is used. The next one, you can add an image. The next one, you can add a video. This is add a section. So add a section means you can have like section wise. If you're clicking on one section, it will go to another section. Okay. So let me do a normal one. The just basic Google form. Now question, add the question. How to add the question? Okay. Name of the path. Name of the participant. And in question, you have different types. One is short answer. Short answer means a student or the customer or the person who is writing the document, who is answering this, can write about 4 to 5 lines. A paragraph means you want to write a 3 to 4 paragraph, then more text is needed, then you can click on paragraph. Then you can see long text. If you're clicking on short text, then you can write only limited to certain lines. Multiple choice question. If you want to give any multiple choice questions, then you can have the multiple choice question. Like that checker box you have, checkbox, you get a checkbox. Okay, then what is the difference between this multiple choice checkbox? I will tell you later. Now drop down, then it is like drop down. From the drop down, you can select. Okay, like if you want to file any upload file, then it will be uploaded. Then the student can upload their photo, the student can upload their documents and all. If you want to file and upload, then if you click on that, then the file will be uploaded by the shell. Then you can set the size here also. Okay, if you want any specific type of files, if you want only PDF files, then you can have PDF files. If you want only image files, then only image files can be added. So you might be seeing that when you are filling the application, only JPEG format is applicable or only PDF format is applicable. Then in such case, you want only specific format, then you can select only specific format. If you don't want any format, then off it, then the responder can file any type of the document he wants. Okay, like that, we have different options, whatever you want, linear scale, this type, linear scale, like you are opting, like you are scaling from 1 to 10, what is your scale, 1 to 5, then what is your scale, that you can have option. The next one is multiple grid choice. Then you can rows and columns. You can have that match the following system. Checkbox, this is also same type. And then if you want only date, like if you want the date of birth, then you can click only dates can be seen. Then the responders can have only date. Okay, so you have time. Then the responders can give only time. So, depending upon the questions, whatever you required, you can select. If you want only short answer, long answer, multiple choice, drop-down list, they want to upload any file, like scaling, okay, multiple choice, date, time. So, these are the options given by the Google form. So, whatever you require, you can have. Now, generally, if you think that name of the participant is generally consists of your short answer, then you can have a short. And there is an option called required. It's mandatory or not. If you're clicking on this, it's a mandatory. It means the form will not accept unless you file the, you give this answer. Okay. If you off it, then it's optional. The respondent can skip the question. If you are owning this, then it's a compulsory question. The respondent want to fill that question. Without that, then the form cannot be submitted. This is one more called duplicate. If you want the same thing duplicate, then you can click on that. Then the duplicate is formed. Okay. But I want to change here name of the participant. Suppose I want hall ticket number. Hall ticket number. So hall ticket number consists number. If you want only number, you can give this. If you want to add any photos also, you can add any photos here. Then by seeing that photo, they can write a description. For example, I'm clicking on this. If you have any upload photos or something, photos you have, then you can see like whatever the photos you have, whatever things you have, you can insert the pic here. Then seeing that pic, so you can add a pic and write the comment on it. Then they can have the comment on it. That type also you can do here. Yes, just I want to delete this again. No need to worry. Just click on delete button. The question will go. Yeah, one again making duplicate. Call ticket number. And you can have the hall ticket number. Can you add next question? Add next question. Okay, after hall ticket number, I want mobile number. If not, instead of mobile number, I want to give year of study. For the student wants to check whether she is studying in first year, second year, something like that. Then you can go for multiple choice here, or you can go for checkbox. Okay, then you can give the options. First year. Or you can have course, you can have, for example, if you have course, BCom, add option. Adoption. Click on add option and you can write BA. Then add option. MBA. Others, see here, if you're clicking on checker box, then it will allow others also. Then if the student belongs to others, then he can add others here separately. Okay, if I'm making, it's a mandatory. Okay. Next one, add button. Like that, whatever you want, you can have the student name, participant, hall ticket number, course. You want anything like mail ID, then you can have mail ID. See, if when you select the mail ID collection, then you can go for mail ID collection. Yes. So this is how whatever you want, you can add the content, whatever the questions you want, you can add the questions. And to see that, just click on preview button. See that? Click on preview button. Now you can see the preview button. Then this is how the form looks like. This is how the forms look like. Name of the participant, hall ticket number, course, type. And if you want to send, if you want to send this, what you have to do is, this is okay. If you want to send this, you can click on send button, then click on link here. There's a very bigger link. Instead of that, if you click on shorter URL, then it becomes shorter URL. Then you can copy it, and the same link I can send to you. My request, I'm going to put the link in the chat box here. I'm going to put the link in chat box. So kindly, everyone, start sharing the screen. I'm putting it on the chat box. So kindly fill that. Then how the response way to download that, we are going to see. Just click on this link, fill the form. Randomly just give some numbers and fill the form. Then how it will be, how you can download the response, we are going to see. Give a thumbs up mark or say yes in the chat box after completing. Then I will show how to download this form. After this, we are going to show how to create a quiz also. With 2 or 3 questions, I'm going to make the quiz to you. Then you can know how to create a quiz, and you can send the same link to your students and other person where they can attend the quiz. The quiz, the marks also, you can see the quiz. Right. Thank you. So after doing that, then how to do, how to check, where are my response? Now see if you can see that. Can everyone see the screen that I'm getting 18 response, right? 19 response, right? Now, what you can do is, suppose, think, okay, now again, save, go to your email account. Again, click on this, go to Google Drive. The same steps again you have to follow. After clicking on that, you can see it. You can see the file, or if you're not able to, this one, click on that. Now you can see the response, 25 response I got. So click on the response button, and if you want to close the response button, I want to close the registration form. Then you can click on this. and whatever the message you want, you can give this message. Now whoever is trying to fill that form, they will get this message for response. This form is no longer accepting response, or whatever the information you want, you can type the information. Okay, registrations are closed. You can write your message. Again, if you want turn on, then click on this, then it will be turned. So you can see all the information, who has submitted the information. You can see the graphs, see how many courses response, BCom 9%, okay, BSc 2%, and you can see the percentage also, 4%, MBA 10 members, okay, MCA 1, BBA 1, and MA 1. Like this, you can see the responder. And if you want to download, just click on this, you can download the responses. Click on that, then it will be downloaded. So be sure that always whatever it is downloading, it will be in a it will be in a zip format. You have to download that. Or what you can do is just click on this create spreadsheet button and say create. Then you can see whatever the information given by the students or whatever it is, see, you can see that all upon when they have submitted the form, it will come along with the time, seconds, date, everything, name of the participant, hall ticket number, course, email ID. So everything it will be coming in this spreadsheet. You want again download this spreadsheet and you can use information further. The way you can make the graphs point to that, you can do. Right, this is how we are going to create a Google form and download the form as per your requirement. Now second thing, we are going to do the same thing. Okay, now I'm going to new one to create the quiz. How to create a quiz? Now I'm creating Google Forms. Okay, now here I want to import some questions like name of the participant, like email ID, this sort, everything is same. Okay, this I'm saying that ICT quiz. I'm putting as ITC quiz. Okay, and I want import questions. Just click on import questions here. You get the list of all the forms which you have created earlier and which from which you want to import. Click on that and select. When you select, you can see all the questions here. So in this, if you want select all, you can select all, or if you want name of the participant, hall ticket number is required, then you can select only those questions. Okay, and say import question. Now you can see that this two questions are added here. Now it saves a time. If you don't want this, okay. Now you can say I have imported two questions like that. How many questions you want, you can import and say import the question. And I want turn this into quiz. Then click on settings. Click on settings and say here it has quizzes. Okay, and make it as quiz, make this as a quiz. Okay, then immediate after each response, grade should be released. Means 10 out of 10 they want to see, then they can see the after submitting, they can see their score. So this all settings I'm saving this. Now name of the participant is there. For this I don't want any answer, so I'm giving their 0 points. The hall ticket number, this also I don't want this thing. Okay, and I'm adding question here. Question: Tally is what type of software? Okay, now this is the question. Option one, you can take multiple choice. The multiple choice option one, it is accounting software. Second one, like this, you can add the image also. Now, in the previous session, Madam has given 4 images, right? If you click on that, then according to that image also, you can add the image and you can select the correct answer for that. The next option is, I want to write here as accounting software or stats software. And admin software, all the above. This you want to, this is a multiple choice question you are giving to them. Okay, now if you don't want this, just click on this, the questions will be removed. Now in this, which is the correct one? Okay, now this is the correct one. I want to make this correct one. So this answer key, click on answer key. Answer key, which is the answer key? Accounting software is the correct answer. So click on that. How many points you want to add? 1 point or 2 points? 1 point, 2 points. For how many points you want, you can add. Then say done. Then likewise, you can have second question. Okay. Tally is used for HR services. For example, I want to take true or false. True. When you say true, say false, it's the suggestion already given. The next one is always false. Okay. I make this a required question. I can click on answer key. Tally is used for HR services, so false. False. Click on done. So like this, we can create a quiz depending upon the number of questions you have. Just like creating the 2 questions. Okay. The how many points? 2 points. 1 and 1. So this is the quiz we have created. Like that, you can add number of questions according to true or false, multiple choice question, drop down buttons, or anything. You can do that. Some more, like I want to add multiple choice question, for example. You can add like row, column, whatever you want. There you can have the row, column. Okay. Tally is used for accounting. Column 1. Office. Manufacturing. Factories. For example, I have done this. 2. Answer point. Answer key. For each point you can add. Accounting. Okay, whichever the correct answer, you can add the correct answer here. I want matching. Accounting, then should be office. Manufacturing, then it should be factories. Okay, I made it. Okay. So like this, whatever you want, you can add the questions. And again, same way, go for preview and check. Check once again. Okay, if it's fine, then go for send option. Click on link. Shorten the link, copy URL. Okay. And posting in the chat box. Like that, you can create it. And everyone can click on that. Same way, after clicking that, you can attend the quiz. You can know the marks on the quiz. There itself you can know. So this is about the Google Forms, how you can connect a quiz. So the second one, the third one, I'm going to show how to use this digital notepad. It's called a digital notepad. We can purchase on online. It's cost, the cost will be around around 3,000 to 10,000. So many varieties of are available in the market. So this what happens, whatever I'm writing here, you got a pen like this, okay, better purchase a pen which does not have batteries. Whatever you're writing here, now you can see the scrolling, right? Whatever you're writing here, that can be viewed to the student. Now how to use this? Okay, just share your screen. I'm sharing entire screen. Take anyone. Now what I'm doing is I'm going for a call note. You have everybody will have this note. This you have send note. You have notes like a office note. You have office note. Just it's like kind of a document. Can you see my screen, everyone? Hello. Yes.
We can see, sir.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you. So just click on tools.
Can you just repeat the procedure, please?
Yes, sir. What we have to do is just go in Windows button, okay, and you can type here office note, or you can write the office note. You have a note, okay, office note. So click on note, then this document will be open. It's an office note. Every MS document have this. Okay, you select the tool here. You select the tool here. You have writing tools, pens, what type of pen you want. Okay, black pen, blue pen, whatever you want, you can select it and you can write. You can write here. Accounts, they can teach accounts, like just like whatever you're teaching there in your accounts. So whatever you want. But this needs some practice. Once you're getting, right, you can like to cash account. Okay, so for accounts, it is useful. Those who are using like Hindi, Sanskrit and all, they can use like this. They can type whatever you want, and the, whatever you are writing here, like this cash account, whatever you are writing, that can be viewed to the student. Okay, and in the tools itself, if you want, so you can have some like a, if you want eraser, then click on eraser. What type of eraser you want? With the pen itself, you can erase it. You can erase it. You can erase it. And whatever you're writing here in tools, we have seen yesterday one option. You can convert. See, create handwriting only. Sorry. Whatever you are writing, that can be converted into text also. Convert handwriting to text. By clicking that, whatever it is recognized, that can be converted into text also. But this requires some practice. It should require. We require some practice. Once if you are getting practice, then it is very easy. So whatever pen you want red pen, then you can use red pen. For Max, for teaching accounts, everything it is useful. So this is how we are going to use with digital pad and digital pen. Okay. So if you want, you can save the file for further. This way you can save. And if this note is not available, then you can go for paint. MS Paint, click on paint button, Then here also you can write here. In Paint also you can write here, and you can save as image and you can send this topic to the student. In MS Paint also you can select, okay? See, you can write whatever you want, you can write. Okay, this is how you can write with the pen. And you can save the image. Whether you can go for that note document or you can go for Paint, you can save the image. I'm saying don't save. So this is way how you can use this tool. Hope everyone has understood. So in today's IC tools, I have shared my insights. How to create a Google form and how to create a quiz. So this, I hope this will help you help you in your teaching. Okay, and this especially pad can be purchased only for the person who want to teach like accounts, like the language teachers can use this. Okay. So once again, I thank the management and entire staff and teachers giving me this opportunity. And I want to end my session. Is only 1 minute, 1.5 minute is available. Then my session will end. Thank you, ma'am, and thank you, sir.
Thank you, Chandrasekhar, sir. That was a very informative session taken by you. In case any faculty members have any queries to ask as doubts or clarifications, you might either unmute yourself or you can put it on the chat box. We have 1 minute of time, so sir can answer your queries in case you have any. Okay, I do not see any. Okay, fine. Please proceed.
Sir, you purchased this online, sir, on Amazon or Flipkart?
I purchased in Amazon, ma'am.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay.
Any further queries? All right. So we will end the session now. I think we have to move on to the last session for today. So we will have to join back with Anjali. Is Anjali there in this meeting?
Yes, ma'am. Good afternoon. All right. Ma'am.
Good afternoon.
I asked you all to join the session at 1:45. I've shared the link in Villa Pillars, ma'am.
Okay. All right. So we will log in again with Anjali's ID at 1:45. Okay. Thank you all. All right.